Hey, everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eat and Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. Woo, man. Once again, we just had a banger of a run that turned stupid at the very end of it. And thank you all very much for the support. Again, shout out to Yuki for doing all the amazing thumbnails, which you can find a link down below, too, if you'd like to go check out his stuff as well. Thank you all very much for the feedback on the new thumbnails. I'm really enjoying it. I'm glad that a lot of people are as well. Yuki is as well. Thank you again. Here's your meme of the day. Beautiful artwork of the day submitted by Shell Shoddy. Title thread was Halloween is soon, so I drew Isaac and friends trick-or-treating with a nice little pumpkin emote. And there's so many Easter eggs built into this. I absolutely love it. If you look real closely, you can spot a whole bunch of, I don't want to say a whole bunch, but a few Sinvicta sort of cameos there. So I'll leave out the ones that you can search for yourself. I don't want to spoil it for you, but obviously, you know, I do want to just give a shout out to little Sissy up there looking all nice, and she is smiling. So thank you very much to Shell Shoddy and everyone who upvoted that one. Hope your Saturdays are going off to a great start. Here we go, everybody. Oh baby, just got done recording some stuff here. Oh man, I see that we have M. Seed Day is going to be X-Ray Quebec Zulu. Lima 9 Zulu X-Ray Juliet. We've got M and Magic Fingers. Well, Magic Fingers making another return here, but we're just going to go ahead and yeet that immediately. Well, as soon as we get a penny, that is. But obviously the big thing here, we're starting off with great movement speed thanks to Speedball. Great shot speed thanks to Speedball. But more importantly, we have ourselves some decent damage and good tiers to start with. 2.92 with 3.87 damage, respectively. And this is a promising start. But even more importantly than that, we've got M, the trinket that does definitely fall under the category of, like, Sinvicta didn't like this item. What is it even doing in my game? This is one of the most broken items that exist in Isaac. I'm not sure how we got hit by that fly there. And what M does, I mean, those of you who've watched the channel for even a short amount of time, you already know what M does. But if you don't know what M does, it will essentially change your spacebar item every single time that you use it. M can result in some wacky, crazy, goofy, off-the-wall results. We've seen Death Certificate come from it. We've seen stuff like Sumptorium come from it. We've seen the D1 Hizzle, of course. I mean, all bets are off when you have M, and that's what I love about the item. It is one of those run-changing, run-shifting items that exist in the game that you would not expect it to be. Same thing goes for something like Dice Bag, where you don't. It's a very unassuming trinket. And next thing you know, you've got yourself a D4, you've got yourself a D100 or a death certificate, and then you're off to the races. And that's what I absolutely love about items like M. You know, that sort of randomness that's baked into the silliness of the item is just truly outstanding. And it's fun. It's just a fun item to play with. And I'm all about fun. I am all about fun, despite the sort of conservative, you know, Sinvicta style that people have now come to know and love and sometimes hate. I'm always in favor of making the game more interesting. And I think that upping the fun value with chaotic items like M is truly spectacular, because this gives you this opportunity to sort of like just experiment. It's like, oh, wow, like we have Magic Fingers. Do we want to keep this or not? Oh, wow, we've got Sumptorium. Do we want to keep this or not? You know, it's pick and choose, giving yourself more options to just destroy the game. And that's what you want to do. That's what you play for. That's what I play for anyway. I want to beat the game as bad as possible. I want to make sure that we are asserting our dominance over the game in every possible way, shape, or form, because you know the game's going to do the exact same thing to you if it gets the chance. So you want to make sure you beat the game before it beats you. And giving yourself all kinds of options, and above all, is having fun while you're doing it, is paramount in my mind. The Magic 8 Ball here, which is going to give us the Chariot, which will allow us to get into and out of the Cursed Room. I'm still obviously holding out hope that we can maybe get options here. Options would be great, now only needing 4 cents. It's the reason why I did not decide to use Magic Fingers yet, because I want to hopefully get it. Obviously, the secret room is north of here. So if we can get into the secret room, that would be nice as well. If that would have hit us, we would have been in a lot of trouble. I'm going to take one stab at a... Okay. The idea there was that if we get one more coin, that I can maybe buy a bomb and get into the secret room. I don't think it's gonna happen though. Yeah, we did get a refund back on 1 cent there. Got a key as well, which is good. We have to hope that there's some good money in the secret room. And there's not, although there is a bomb. Now we can use this bomb to either bomb one of these pots and hope for a miracle quarter, or bomb one of the skulls. On top of that, we could also look for the super secret room, which may have money in it. Usually it doesn't. We have to hope for the Iamera room in there. You know, the one that usually has Ragman in it? Yeah, we have to hope for that one. And it's going to be pretty obviously here. Oh my goodness. Well, hang on a second. Now this is interesting now, because even though I wasn't planning on picking up that half soul heart, however, now that we have all those red hearts in there, we can now play the sacrifice room. So it's not over yet, folks. It's not over yet. The womb room was another avenue that I was not expecting to have here. So this is going to be pretty big. Although this is going to be quite annoying for us to have to go all the way back and forth like this. This is a play that we have to make. You know, we're not in any danger in this run, because the start is phenomenal, to be sure. But this is how we're going to maximize our chances, taking the time as needed to go back and forth here, and just give ourselves more advantages to make up for the loss of advantages later on in the run, whatever they may be, if they may be. So we get blanked on the 50-50 both times there. So now what we are working with is we have to hope that we get the chest. The three coins here, if we want to have any chance of getting options. And all this is in favor of us, again, making good, smart decisions early on. In the sacrifice room, it's just another one of those examples that if you can take advantage of it, definitely do it. So we didn't get the 3 cents either, but we did gain the Angel Deal chance, which doesn't mean anything, obviously. And now we have a chance to get teleported to the Angel Deal, which could also lead to some bigger and better things. But again, it's a little bit laborious having to go back and forth like this, but it's what we have to do. This is the game testing our resolve, testing our gumption. You know, is he really going to go back and forth and do this? Absolutely, game. Of course, we get a red chest. But now we have a 33% chance to get an Angel Deal item. And yes, it is very tempting for me just to pick up these soul hearts just so we don't have to go back and forth, but those soul hearts are going to be instrumental in letting us take our Devil Deal on the next floor. Even if we get an Angel Deal item here, we're going to have plenty of HP to get a solid Devil Deal item on the next floor. So very long start here to this one, and we don't get an Angel Deal item either, but we did get another soul heart, so it's good. So now we are essentially just turning our red hearts into soul hearts. The possibility of us getting options is no longer on the table, which is unfortunate, but that's Invicta luck, baby. You can just, I mean, if you're watching this on YouTube, I mean, of course you're watching this on YouTube, but if you're watching this at normal speed, at times one speed, definitely skip through this, because it's still going to take a while. We're seeing this through to completion here. Whether it be for the 30 cents, which is the only other thing that can happen now at this point, but I think that we already know that that's not going to happen. Or the 7 soul hearts, which is coming up after this tap from Uriel. So here we go. This is the last gasp that we have for options. And you might be asking yourself, is options worth this? And the answer is yes, it is. It's very much so worth this. You know, regardless of what the situation is that you're in, you know, whether or not you have the patience or the impatience to deal or not to deal with this respectively, it has nothing to do with the item. The item that you're trying to get is still good. Yeah, so exactly the way that I told you it would be, and yeah, so we're not gonna get options, unfortunately. We end up coming away with a lot of HP, though, and that's about it. We did all that for essentially what is an easy-peasy devil deal acquisition on the next floor. I'm going to take the Rotten Heart as well, just because I want to have a little bit of extra damage. So very long first floor, but we got there. And you know, sometimes those are just the plays you got to make, man. Sometimes you just got to give yourself the best chance, put yourself in the position to succeed the best you can. We're going here. We've got tons and tons of HP, and we're about to get even more. In fact, we're about to get so much more. I'm going to wait on getting that because it gives us 3 soul hearts. There's no reason for us to take it right now unless if I'm afraid of forgetting it, which is definitely a possibility, let's just be honest. Hopefully I don't forget about this Invicta robes. If I do, yell at me. Of course, we did get Rotten Tomato, which is going to paint the targets red. And any target that gets painted red will basically draw the aggravation of everything in the room for a short amount of time. And it's very good, especially if they deal contact damage like spiders or mulligans or mullabooms or anything like that. It's very good for taking them out. It's just a better version of Charm. We do get the Crystal Ball, which in and of itself is a very good item to have for us on this run. But you know, obviously with M, we want to try to spice it up a little bit more. So now M has turned Crystal Ball into the moving box. And the nice thing about M is that, again, we can essentially pick and choose. We have nothing but time and nothing but the entirety of the space bar item pool to select from, to really give us, like, you know, hey, do we want to stop on moving box, or hey, you know, what's situationally better for us? Is the glowing hourglass better? Is the crystal ball better? You know, that sort of stuff is what I mean when I say run shifting, is run defining. And that is what M gives you right out of the box. I mean, no pun intended, but yeah, it is a phenomenally well-designed item, and I think that more stuff like that for the future of Isaac is going to be healthy. Just putting more power in the player's hands to really pick and choose what they want. Get Yuckheart here. It's Limehorn. I'm definitely hoping that we get some kind of damage upgrade, if possible. I'm not opposed to re-rolling this run if we get down to it with M, but you know, obviously a death certificate would be nice. I've been seeing C-section a lot, obviously, as you've been seeing from the thumbnails and stuff. Like to get something a little bit different. HP upgrade, and yeah, I'm gonna take both of them just because A, I want to get rid of our red hearts, and B, because we want to give ourselves reroll fodder just in case if we end up using the D4. Now, I do see that we have another sacrifice room here, which is what I'm going to go for. If you're wondering why I tapped the temperance machine, by the way, it's because I want to get rid of our heart so we have empty vessel just for flying. We don't need red hearts right now. And you can definitely bet your bottom dollar we're going to be playing this one as well down to completion, except this time we don't have to run all across the map for it. Now, of course, we get all the coins and when we don't need it. Already been to the devil deal, so this doesn't matter. The soul heart back, okay. And there we go. We can go pick up the Sinvicta robes. I didn't forget. We'll pick up the Sinvicta robes for the damage up, obviously, as well as the HP, and we are good to be Gucci. Notice right there, nice, neat little trick that I show off every now and then. If you can get out of the curse room before the hearts are allocated to you after picking up something that gives you soul hearts, like Sace and Ceremonial Robes, you will not incur the penalty of the curse room going out, because technically speaking, you haven't picked up the item yet. As a quick reminder as well, those of you, I've been getting a couple of questions asking about the Patreon. What kind of benefits are there other than joining the Discord? You get to have those neat little shout-outs at the end of every single Isaac episode that we do on the channel. Somebody asked, they said that they signed up this month for Patreon, as in like October. And first off, thank you very much. And secondly, they wanted to know when will their name be shouted out on there? And the answer to that, the answer to that is starting in November. So it doesn't, the membership benefit, or the Patreon benefits do not kick in until a month, until the processing on Patreon has gone through, essentially. So like if you signed up on the last day of October, it's not going to go through until November at some point. Now, if you sign up in early November, but after the processing has taken place, which is before the Patreon team, the Synvicta Patreon team sees it and it's not processed yet, then you won't go on November. You'll go on December. So hopefully that makes sense. I love doing the shout outs at the end of the episodes. It's a very quick and easy way to say thank you for those of you who support me on Patreon. I've had a couple of ideas come and go in terms of merchandise for Patreon. I think that merch is something that I definitely want to do, like Patreon exclusive merchandise, to basically just give backers and that sort of thing, or patrons, whatever you want to call yourselves. I want to do something different than I've done in the past, so which I haven't fully committed to an idea yet. You're wondering why I'm not using. Yuck Heart right now, just to roll it with M. It's because I'm waiting to get rid of this Red Heart. I'm waiting to get rid of this, essentially. I don't want to lose the shield. Kind of hoping that we were going to get a little bit more help from the High Priestess. So we didn't get anything. Get the matchbook. Now I'll roll it. Get the moving box again. The first time I've used the reverse Priestess card in a while. And probably the last. It was just too tempting not to use. The High Priestess, or the reverse High Priestess card, will give a Mom Stompy Foot every so often for a minute. It's not permanent, thankfully, but I don't see the point of it, because it doesn't benefit Isaac in any which way, shape, or form. It only does that. Now, if it actually targeted enemies, that'd be a different story altogether. Oh wow, moving box actually remembered that it used. We used it on the other floor and held the that heart that we picked up. I didn't realize that it was programmed like that. It's pretty cool. Okay, you see the aggravation there of the painting of Rotten Tomato. So good at taking down very aggressive enemies, Cubones or Diglets or Mullabooms. Gives us Mom's box, and we give everyone a full clear. Wow. I probably could have waited for the Horf to try to open that for me, but meh. The Decapitation. And the Jar of Souls, which I'm just going to use immediately, and we get Eden Soul. So now comes the unfortunate part about M, which is that it will, if you get the single if you get the single use space bar items, then you know it doesn't roll again. However, speaking of rolling, if we get enough money here, you may have seen that we did have a reroll machine inside of the secret room, and with Eden's soul, that's going to give us the ability to spawn two items in there, and then we can reroll at our leisure. So, pretty amazing shot by those chubs. You know, empty vessel greatly benefiting here from having an orbital. Get a golden bomb as well, which is nice. And yeah, we absolutely have enough to make a run at a secret room item. And on top of that, if we don't get enough charges, we have that charge baby in the arcade now. So we will 100% guaranteed get a reroll on our space bar on our secret room items here. So let's go fight the boss real quick. It's going to be a pretty easy peasy hollow. Fortunately, they don't aggravate to each other, but if they are both painted and they run into each other, they'll deal damage to each other, which is nice. But hollow doesn't have any, or at least regular non-champion hollow doesn't have any aggro like table on it or anything. Get Tropicamide, which is going to give us a tier's size up and range, and yeah. Now, could we have waited on Eden's Soul for the Devil Deal instead of the Secret Room? Yeah, we could have, but the thing is that there's no reroll in the Devil Deal, so passing up a Secret Room reroll is just too much to not do. That's just too valuable there. You can get so many good items out of that. Harlequin Baby, which Ghost Baby, I'm fine with. Harlequin Baby is okay if you like that sort of shotgun effect that she has, but for the most part, I'm not fretting. We don't really have damage to give right now in terms of conjoined. So there we go. We did a full clear essentially and did not have enough to charge Eden's Soul. We're down by two charges. However, we do have the charged beggar in here. There we go. That's all we needed to do. He's about to pay out with something, and I'm not sure what, but it is an R key. Pyro's not bad. All right. Now the only problem is the only problem with this now is that this completely invalidates M. But with Glitch Crown, this gives us an opportunity to possibly get a Omega run going. Maybe, possibly. We got to go light side first. Well, dark side then light side first. So. You're going to, during this transition, you're going to possibly see the video pause. I'm just going to use the phone real quick here. Sorry about this pause. Sorry about that. Whenever we use R key, it's not going to replenish us with another space bar item from M. It's just simply going to consume R key, and then that's it. But we will still maintain M. So the plan now, if we're going to try to make this Omega run happen, which we haven't done one in a while, the plan now will be to go. We have to start with Lamb, do a victory lap, then go to Delirium. But in order for us to do that, we have to get past the Mega Satan block. So because it all stops then. So the Omega run is not possible. And then from there, we have to get another R key, or there has to be a teleport. We have to get a teleport out of the mother room and then be able to go find a sacrifice room in Corpse 2 in order for us to get teleported to the dark room again, do a victory lap, and then we can kill Beast. So it sounds like a lot, which it is. Omega runs are, of course, very difficult to do. A buddy Samito was able to get an Omega run, which it's always neat whenever you hear someone use a term that you came up with. I came up with the term Omega run, the idea of doing every single boss in one unbroken run. And me and my video gamer brain was just like, oh, we got to call it an Omega run. And then hearing other people use it and say, like, I got an Omega run, is like, that's so awesome to see kind of, you know, proliferate around the lingo for the Isaac community and Isaac world. So it's very neat. And Samito's Omega run was awesome. We've got to go euthanasia here for Spun. So it's 2 of 3 for Spun on euthanasia. And euthanasia is not a bad tier effect either, especially if you can manage to proc it on like small enemies with serious liquid. Witch Crown is going to flip-flop between 5 items on every single item pedestal, which, as you can probably tell, is it gets out of control in a hurry. And again, going back to the concept that I was discussing earlier in this video on floor 1, when we were talking about having just more opportunities equals stronger runs, equals more fun, and it puts more power into the player's hands, really. And I'm all for that. Come on. So we don't have to worry about getting angel deals here on this run, because we're not going to go fight Mega Satan here. What we want an empty vessel for the flying more than anything else, because early game flying, even mid game flying, is very, very strong. Gotta go damage here. Honestly, I'm gonna just skip these. I mean, you know, having Bloody Lust is fine and Cambion Conception is fine, but it's not what we're looking for right now. We need stats. So we get some decent damage ups there in the form of Stapler. And now we're starting to get a little bit of something going. Nothing too crazy. I also have to pray that I don't accidentally hit R key. Now, if we happen to get another space bar item, then yeah, we're good to roll and stuff with M, because of the fact that we have school bag, which we picked up blind, if you recall. Sissy, how you doing, Sissy? Little Sissy. Good to see you, Sissy. We're now blessed by Sissy. She's here, and look at that. We get a free, we get a free angel deal anyways, or access to the golden door anyway. We don't even need the angel deals. But we've got Sissy. Sissy, it's been so long, Sissy. I mean, technically there, the play was going to be like Loki's horns, but I digress. Or Friend Finder. Friend Finder would have also not been too terrible. If and only if for us to have something else to reroll in the spacebar item slot thanks to M, but I mean, come on, it's Sissy. We made the correct choice. Everyone knows what the actual correct choice was. It was Sissy. Sorry. A 7-cent keeper sack, sign me up. And PH Dizzle. The Keeper Sack is going to start us off right here by giving us some stat ups. Oh, baby, and Birthright as well. No! we could not have picked a worse one, Sissy. Now we got to go Black Candle here. That is one thing that's annoying about Glitch Crown is that you have to compensate for not only what item, like the timing and picking up the item pedestal, but also the speed that you need to be able to make up the gap of you separated from the item pedestal itself. And because we got a speed up there, I was a little bit too close to the pedestal for me to get there and then with the timing. Getting real tired of us getting nailed by these little chip shots here in their game. Not there. Could be here. Okay, so we get our nickel here, which is going to allow us to maybe get Black Candle. I don't usually miss on Glitch Crown. I do occasionally, but then we have to go negative here. No deal with the devil. Womp, 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 womp. Okay. Ooh, I saw a tinted rock up there. I'd be saying, how did you see that so fast? You were in there for less than a second. I know what tinted rocks look like. You play this game long enough, you just kind of know. Okay, good. All right. We are on our way to the magical world of the correct wayism. This is the way. He said the thing from Mandalorian. I like The Mandalorian. Definitely my favorite of the Star Wars shows. Looking forward to season 3. Anytime I hear This Is the Way, I can't not hear the armorer played by Emily Swallow on The Mandalorian's voice. Very cool. My friend Allie from Titan Cards. They had like a 2-year wrap up or 30,000 sub video where they did a cameo. They actually had Emily Swallow do a cameo as the armorer, which was really, really cool. And I was like, man, I wish that I had like that kind of, I wish that I had the ability to do like just a new cameo every single Isaac episode, but that would get ridiculously expensive. But then I'm like, who would I do? Who would I even ask to do a cameo? It can't be Gilbert Gottfried anymore. Obviously his time has unfortunately come to an end, but I don't get a tears up. Our tears was good to start the run, but it's no longer good now. It'd be cool to be famous enough to do Cameo. Yeah, to have someone pay for your voice to say like happy birthday, or you know, to be known enough to where people would be like freaking out, like, oh my god, they got so and so, you know, and, like, at the same time, like, I don't really want to be that known either, because it's kind of like, lifestyle just ain't for me, man. Gotta go Mr. Dolly here for the tears up. The Guppy's head or Death's touch? I'm gonna go Death's touch here, actually. And then over here, I don't really care about, to be honest. I mean, we could get the quarter, but Death's touch was essentially free almost, thanks to Mr. Dolly. That'd be neat. I just really want to be a voice actor. That's like my not so hidden ambition and dream. I'd love to be a voice actor in a major video game or major like motion picture series or something like that. That would be amazing. That's the ultimate dream for me. I think my voice is rather unique enough to be instantly recognizable, which is good and bad. Like, I don't like my voice. I mean, it's like very Homer Simpson sort of frog-ish. So I don't know. It's weird for even me to try to describe my own voice, because it feels like it's self-glossing in a way. I'll let the mosh pit down below in the comments kind of describe my voice. Okay, good. All right, there we go. There's the entire map, everybody. We did it. Chance of us doing an Omega run fades by the minute, because I don't think I want to do this for 2 hours, but let's see. Death touch, of course, gives us scythe tears. On top of that, gives us the very important piercing shots, which is what we need for the most value out of mysterious liquid. It's only going to cost us a soul heart to get into the curse room, so it's worth trying at least. Especially with a glitch crown, you just never know. Okay, good. One thing we do know is that you can 9 out of 10 times predict that we are just going in the wrong direction. There's an over-under for Vegas on how many times Sinvicta will be going the wrong way in a run. It'd be well over, like, just take the over every single time. Just don't even bother. I'm actually going to pass on the Eternal Heart. We want to have the Empty Vessel Shield. Obviously, we're not going to make Hush, even if we wanted to. Unless we use the Gaujo Free card, which I'm not going to do. Because I do not want to fight Hush with a build this weak right now. It's not weak. It's not the most horrible that we've seen, obviously. But it's not. We're not in a good spot in terms of like overall like face roll dominance yet. We're getting there, but we gotta get some more. We gotta make some more plays here. Now, you definitely could make an argument that we should go fight Hush no matter what, just because of the fact that we have Glitch Crown and we also have Keeper Sack, but yeah, so we get Guppy's Collar or Brimstone. We could take Damocles as well, which is not a bad choice for Glitch Crown, but the problem is that I don't have faith in us getting all the way to land without taking a hit. Take Brimstone here. I'm gonna leave that there. I know. I know. Trust me, it's hard to leave Succubus or Babylon there. But I'm hedging my bets because obviously we've got to go fight Lamb, which means we have to go down to the Dark Room, which means that we are going to have four Devil Deals to contend with. And because we have Glitch Crown, we're going to need every little bit of HP we can get for buying, like, you know, important items. So notice how we painted Lil Loki there. Or not Lil Loki, but Limehorn. And the Mr. Mies went right after him. One bomb for four blue fires is a pretty good trade. Even if we didn't get anything for him. I wasn't looking for the Super Seeker Room or regular Seeker Room. I was just bombing the skulls to see if we can get a black skull. We didn't. Go back and go to the blue fires in here. Oh, there are blue fires somewhere. Yeah, here they are. Gonna be Stanley. Okay, look at that. One was charmed by Sissy, the other one was painted by Rotten Tomato. Good job, Sissy. Oh, I don't know about that one game. It's a little bit, it's always weird whenever Satan does the sideway brimstone, but you're like, or the downward brimstone, but you're off to the side of him, but you somehow still get kind of tagged there. So let's see if the hedging the bets works. Now, we don't have a whole lot of HP to work with, so I'm a little bit concerned about being able to take everything that we want here. These mascara would be pretty huge for damage. None of these really sticking out other than Ease Mascara for the damage. To take the Ease Mascara. So now we have significant damage for Brimstone, but we have to worry about our HP. And taking D-Bizzle is definitely something I want to do, but we just cannot afford to do so right now. Not yet, anyway. If we had a couple more Soul Hearts, give me one or two more Soul Hearts, and then we'll take D-Bizzle. Something's wrong. I could feel it. Yeah, that's just powerful damage there with Brimstone. Eve's Mascara. A little spicy on these dodges. And if we don't get Dark Bomb, we don't get Dark Bomb. I mean, it's the best bet is to stay alive right now. Got lucky that we didn't get rung up there. You go, one cage rolled into the other. They both dealt contact damage to each other, thanks to Rotten Tomato. Sissy. Little Sissy instantly charming the bomb lamprey flies as they're running towards one another, and then they both just collide, and that's it. Little Sissy. Sissy. Saw that sort of weird angle that the Invisidemons kind of took And that was because one of the demons was painted by a rotten tomato. I'm waiting for the 39th minute to go off. I think that's when our next empty vessel shield kicks in. The very long first run here. If we didn't have our key, I normally would just be calling it here probably. Just to save my voice a little bit of strain. But because we have our key, we're gonna try to go for it. Been a while since we've done it. Yeah, Sissy or Rotten Tomato is just a direct counter to Lamb. Phase two, she messes Lamb's world. Absolutely going to do a victory lap. Let's try to get it, Mosh Pit. Click that like button. Second run. Delta 96, Delta 1, Sierra 4, Golf. It's little Sissy Saturday. Sissy Saturday. I like it. Sorry. All right, so now the operative word here is stats, and we're going to do so by way of Keeper Sack. There's options as well, which is definitely something we want. Slightly too slow on that one. Range up's gonna be very useful for our Brimstone. Hey, at least we don't have to worry about curses. I'm going to go back to the item room here just so we can say that we gave ourselves every possible opportunity. We're starting with a floor one planetarium here. Monsumer's Revenge. Definitely want Uranus as well. Or we'll just get Pluto. Little off today. Pluto's not bad though. We do get the tiers up, which is good for our DPS. But would have rather had Uranus. And I guess we'll go for a latch key here. Or we'll take HP. Okay, Brain, you need to figure this out, because this is imperative that we nail these Glitch Crown pedestals down. Whether it means getting closer to these targets or just not being stupid, taking the wrong pedestal is not ideal. Keeper Sack again. Rather have, honestly, the Tears Up or Isaac's Tomb. Isaac's Tomb is going to give us an item or Soul Hearts at the start of every single floor, which is very good. Wow, you got to admit, that was a pretty nice play there with Monsumer's Revenge and Brimstone, taking out both of the champions like that. Gotta take Psyfly here. Not going to overthink it. I mean, Spider Bite's great, obviously. Getting card reading would be nice as well. For the main reason to save time, if we're going for an Omega run. We don't need bombs that bad, so we just get out. My God. Oh. Double blast from Brimstone and Montezuma's. Use his freaking shadow, which I'm definitely going to take. If we can get it. Thank you, Pluto. Appreciate it. Okay, so we don't have to worry about We do not have to worry about getting Angel Keys right now because we have Get Out of Jail Free card. Oof, man. That double blast of Montezumas and Brimstone is just so, so strong. I think we go Synthoil here. Gonna give a Spun anyway. You might be saying, how come you need to take growth hormones? Well, because we're gonna get a movement speed from Spun anyway. Synthoil, I think, is a greater damage upgrade magnitude wise than growth hormones is. Money here. Pluto, by the way, if you're wondering why I was blaming Pluto on that, it's because Pluto drops your hitbox size, which also includes your pickup size, which is kind of dumb, but the size down that you get from Pluto is also kind of annoying. Again, Eucormycosis here. Two wouldn't be bad. Or we could get more options. Hey, we didn't bung it this time. More options. The golden question mark, or whatever you want to call it, is going to give us a second item pedestal in every single item room that we come to, which is very good for us. Again, with Glitch Crown, assuming I'm able to actually hit the pedestals that I want. So we know the item room is right at the beginning here. Fortunately, Isaac's tomb is not playing nice with us. I was hoping that we were going to get some more HP from it. Pentagram, which is going to give us a nice damage upgrade. Second Brimstone. 9 lives as well. We can't bung the 9 lives. Oh my god, I hate everything about Pluto. I hate it. We were right on the freaking hearts too, man. Well, we're paying for our mistake of accidentally taking Pluto by... Oh, good. We get one makes you small, which is going to make us even trickier to see on the screen. I'm so mad that we missed 9 lives there. I even made sure that I was aiming for, like, what I thought was the icon. I get Steam Sail here. I mean, at this point, I don't even know where our hitbox is. Got the Steam Sail. Now we just got to go get treasure map. So we have to hope that the Devil Deal is still open for us to get double Brimstone. But, I mean, do we want to go down to one half of a heart here with Pluto? I don't know, man. That's a tall order right there. Here's up. Well, I was trying to get the joystick for the tears up. It's not a significant tears up, but it's still annoying that we keep missing these items here just by a hair. The only thing that's bad about this now is just, yeah, we're not going to get brimstone anyway. The only thing that's bad about this now is that, like, if we do, oh my gosh, Isaac's Tomb, please give us HP or items. Stop giving us trinkets. I think it's only given us trinkets since we had it. We have to pretty much take HP here. And there's nothing in the devil deal. Two soul hearts here. I kind of want to just go down to the next floor, but we're not in a position to where this is like... This is, so far anyway, this is not Omega Run worthy. If I had been getting the items that I've been wanting to take, it'd be different. Now we do have the D4, which at this point I'm honestly willing to roll on it. I don't want to re-roll Little Sissy. Our damage is incredible. But we also may... Oh yeah, that's right, we have no flying. We also run the risk of re-rolling our key as well, which would defeat the whole purpose of this victory lap. That, and I kind of don't want to get rid of Keeper Sack or use Mascara, really. Or Brimstone, for that matter. We don't have to re-roll, but we could. And I gotta remember we have no flying. Jacob's ladder wouldn't be bad here. Take Jacob's ladder. We could have taken a book there just to have, if we wanted to continue using M, we wouldn't have to roll with the D4. Oh my god, please. You know what? You can have that chess game. I don't even care. We are struggling right now with Pluto. We need to find the shop. Gotta keep up with the damage. 32 damage is obviously excellent. But you can always have more. If we're going to be fighting Delirium for an Omega Run possibility, we got to deal more damage. We also got to get more HP. We also have to find the right way to go, which, for us, that means that that's an improbability of impossible measures. All right. So there's the... Mob trap room, everybody. Got there? Nice. Let's go find the shop, shall we? Mom's key. I'm not going to go for restock, just go for blanket here. All right. We may still reroll this. We may still reroll it. Go straight to Mom. We have no money. We have to do boss rush anyway. We'd probably Proptosis or Lusty Blood. Either one of them will work. Take Proptosis. Just for the massive point-blank damage we get. Diplopia. We could use Diplopia and make it to where we don't have to worry about re-rolling with the D4. Oh yeah, we don't have enough money. Obviously, if we're going for Omega Run, we got to do Boss Rush no matter what. So now is the perfect time for us to do that. And, you know, despite our damage, it's the backtracking that we're doing currently that is making us kind of lag behind here. Not really lag behind, but, you know, we could be going faster. Yeah, I'm not even going to try to bother planting bombs or moving chests with this. You get Purthro now, and Purthro is going to allow us to reroll. It's basically a D6. Obviously, we need to hold on to the get-out-of-jail-free card if we want to have access to the Devil Deal or to the Mega Satan fight. What Diplopia here. Then we're going to take Deep Pockets. We got good damage gains there. Then what we can do is then we can use Diplopia on the boss rush to get an extra item. This is very clearly not the right way to go. In fact, I should have known this wasn't the right way to go since we were working back towards the beginning. Gonna be off of the big room up here. Soul of Lazarus, which is not gonna help us out, but I know that it's there. Yeah, thanks to Proptosis, we're dealing massive amounts of damage. If anything is dumb enough to stay close to us, yeah, they're gonna get absolutely melted. Yeah. Down goes Mom. We do get a Devil Deal here. It's gonna be Guppy's Paw, maybe. Okay, Devil Deals are just impossible to take with this. I would love to get NRI. So we've got a whole lot of options now. Take Tractor Beam on this one, take NRI on the other. Not. An absolutely massive damage here. Remember, we got to go down to Delirium this time around, so means we also have to fight Hush. Love to get Host Hat here. Actually, no, we don't want the D8. Host Hat for explosion immunity. And I'm going to take one final attempt to try to get Inner Eye. He's done it. Don't like taking the damage that's required for that, but it's worth it for the split shot. And here's the hoping that we get red portals. We didn't. Should take all this for the old Hushy shop. But obviously, Inner Eye is just gonna be massive amounts of damage that we need to do. Gives us good spread. It does destroy our tears rate, but it gives us good everything else. That was definitely worth coming back to for sure. I think that we were on the right way to go to the boss of the southeast corner here. By that I meant down here to go get some HP, of course. There we go. That goes Fallen. And we could get Guppy's Hairball. At this point, I'd rather get Incubus, though. Incubus would give us Conjoined, unfortunately. But with Brimstone, I think that's okay. I think it could join, which is going to give us a ton more Brimstones to go through. Once again, we did not get a red portal. Right. At least we can sort of infer where the boss room is from here on out. But still, it'd be a lot better if we could just get teleported to the, you know, boss room. Love to get rid of our HP here as well, just so we can get back our flying. Look at that. So much damage from Brimstone. Proptosis on top of having the Euthanasia effect proc. Zay! We get our double deal here. And I'm going to go for Mark. Then we also want Pact here. Or Maul of the Void. Either one works. There we go. We get the Leviathan transformation. Now we're starting to rock some pretty good damage. Remember, we still got to go up. We've got to go up to go fight Blue Baby. And then Megastan. Do not want Ipecac here. Station 2 is going to be nice. Oh, baby. Cammy's head. I think that's where we say goodbye to our friend M. Thank you, M, for making it possible. Although, M could lead us to a death certificate, which may be better than Tammy's head if we're going for a Omega run. I'm going to risk not doing that, though, and just stick with the plan here with Tammy's head, because Tammy's head is just an absolutely atrocious amount of damage and allows us to destroy everything on the way to where we need to be going. I'm not getting bothered with this cardio coin here. Oh man. Okay. Wow. That is some powerful damage there. Overlapping Monsoon's Revenge with Brimstone here. Along with Polypheme or Proptosis. Yeah. That is some strong damage right there. You get a red portal, which is great. It fills up our HP here. Tammy's head's gonna mollywop Isaac. Yeah, Team Carry Cat. All right, so here's what we need. We need to beat Mega Satan and have the run not end. We need it. We need to get a Delirium Portal. Oh man, Spoonbender. Parasite might crash the game. Definitely want Tiny Planet here. And we'll go for Sulfur for damage. Don't really need Bird's Eye. Oh. Team Carry Cat, it's great to see you back. Oh, baby. So we did not get a Delirium Portal here from Blue Baby, obviously. So now we're hoping that we get one from Megastan. And if we don't, well, then the run's over. So gonna go Miter here. I do also have Nun's Habit, so if we do get hit by something, we can instantly recharge Tammy's head. I don't think that that's going to be a problem, though, given how much damage we're doing with things just dying on spiders. Oh, my goodness. Mega Stan's like, see ya. Even Montezuma's Revenge gets the benefit of Spoonbender. And we don't get the portal. Didn't happen. That's disappointing because that run would have destroyed. I mean, we would have destroyed everything regardless. But with Tammy's head showing up, man, that's a shame. I really wish that they would just make it, just do this once for the unlock and then just never have it come up again for the character, because there's no reason to end the run there when you don't want to. I hate leaving stuff to chance, but either way, thank you for watching, everyone. Very fun run, very long run, but we had a lot of fun nonetheless here, and shout out to Glitch Crown for making it possible, and M as well. M had a pretty big role in that early on, so thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, it supports my channel. Subscribe and ring the notification bell down below. Of course, if you'd like to support, you can also leave comments, that sort of thing. It goes a long way with helping the channel with the algorithm and grows it, and it brings a lot more people to the mosh pit. I love having you here, so thank you, everyone. Have a great start to your weekend, and as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Min Win, Shock Top, Rake 409, and Nikolai Nenchev. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find down below or by going to patreon.com/Sinvicta.